No, none of y'all motherfuckers here with no Instagram, nobody living, nobody at, and I don't want to hear shit from none of these niggas, Jewish niggas talk about, oh, he's in an episode. Harley Pasternak follow me to the fucking hotel. The nigga kill Aaron Carter, and now they acting like they won't kill, clear the Backstreet Boys sample. You get what I'm saying? Harley Pasternak, Pusha, your trainer. Harley Pasternak, Jay-Z. You get what I'm saying? And then niggas be hanging around these niggas just for the money or some Mike Rubin shit. I slap the shit out of Mike Rubin. I see that nigga. You know what I'm saying? It's like, yo, fuck it. Fuck these niggas, bro. They sabotaged the show today. They sabotaged the Instagram. They cut off the fucking Adidas contract. They did all the shit. Then they want to go get Light Skin Ye. You got to say it. That's Jerry. His real name is Light Skin Ye, bro. Deadass, he told me that was his name. It's Light Skin Ye. They want the light skin version. They want a George Floyd. They want a Virgil. They're like, then don't let me speak at the funeral. I saw 2, 3, 4, 5 white people not let me speak at funeral. None of y'all niggas and Drake, nigga. And hold on, be quiet while I'm talking, baby. A lot of people had shit to say about my Jewish comments, but ain't nobody in this motherfucking room and none of y'all entertaining niggas ever said nothing when I was praying to see my kids one of the last days. What's my nigga that got fucking locked up for the Megan Stallion shit?
Oh, Tory Lanez.
Okay, look. So Tory Lanez called me. We were saying prayers. All y'all niggas on Instagram got some shit to say. Y'all niggas saw this shit. Don't tell me about my fucking political opinion. I made more money to show you that money ain't nothing. It's our money, nigga. It's our country, nigga. It's how they stole it from us. It's pyramids, nigga. It's pyramids. It's St. Louis, nigga. Missouri. They stole it. All the shit. America just the latest bitch that been ran through so many times. The Greeks hit her. Massa Musa hit her. We had her. The Indians and shit. The motherfucking pilgrims. It's the Jewish niggas. They dress the same, nigga. It's the same shit. That's the story. They put us in the school. The Rothschilds. I know Jay-Z back here like, oh, this nigga gonna die now. I've been here for a year, my nigga. They can't fucking touch me. Why? Because God covered me. We don't have to bow to this shit, nigga. Okay, it's 60 million of us in America, 60 million Jews in the world. 50% of our deaths is abortion. 25% of us go to prison. Raise one hand if you don't know one nigga in prison, one nigga got locked up, and one nigga poor. Raise your hand if you don't know one person got abortion. Now I tell you, if it was in a Jewish mother on Friday with no fucking, everybody raised their hands. So, wait a second. But wait a second. Who make the hospitals, though? Who got the hospitals? These are Zionists, nigga. This is what I'm trying to tell you. Jesus Christ, Hitler, yay. Third party, sponsor that, nigga. Bring the sponsorships to that.
So that was Kanye. And if you are aware of anything that has happened with Kanye last year, you can see he is still on the same racist energy as before. Hi, this is Sun Tsunami, fan of good music, and someone that is trying to get out our dreams. That rant you saw a few moments of happened after a listening party that was days before the quote-unquote release of Vultures. Now, I don't want to break down any of the rant. I'll post the link if you want to watch it, but this video is on everything prior to this blow-up. We're going to talk about Kanye with some depth. So kick back, watch me win/lose in Street Fighter, and let's start. All of this Kanye turmoil started in October of last year. The reason for this was due to his actions that he took during the Yeezy Season 9 fashion show, where he wore the White Lives Matter t-shirt with Candace Owens. Now, at this point in the timeline, Adidas is pissed, but they're reviewing their deal with Kanye. From there, Kanye starts getting blocked on social media by continuing the anti-Semitism train that he was on. He says Diddy is being controlled by Jews, and he gets suspended on Instagram. Then he goes on Twitter, when it was Twitter, and drops the controversial tweet generations of people may remember him by. And the day after, Kanye has an interview with Tucker fucking Carlson.
So you just came from Paris Fashion Week, you just landed, and your lanyard's still on from it, and there's a photograph on it. What is that?
It's a photograph of a baby's ultrasound. I don't care about people's responses. I care about the fact that there's more black babies being aborted than born in New York City at this point. That 50% of black death in America is abortion. It's like with David, you know, he tended to the sheep, but while he was out there, he had to fight all kinds of animals. So when it was time for Goliath to come, he thought because he was a sheep herder that he didn't have the skill set to take down Goliath. And the thing that I have is the position, I have my heart, but the number one thing is we have God on our side. I do certain things from a feeling. I just channel the energy. It just feels right. It's using a gut instinct, a connection with God, and just brilliance. Planned Parenthood was made by Margaret Sanger, a known eugenics, with the KKK to control the Jew population. When I say Jew, I mean the 12 lost tribes of Judah, the blood of Christ, who the race, the people known as the race black, really are. This is who our people are, the blood of Christ. This, as a Christian, is my belief. And I believe that if we saw ourselves as more, I was biting my tongue on my political opinion because I thought it would be better for my children. And now you look up and my kids are going to a school that teaches black kids a complicated Kwanzaa. I prefer my kids knew Hanukkah than Kwanzaa. At least it will come with some financial engineering. Kwanzaa doesn't, you know, so they don't teach even Christmas itself, Christmas.
I'm sorry, I'm starting to see why they want to make you be quiet.
On here, he is just emboldened to spit more rhetoric against the Jewish community. It is not until the end of the month that companies like JP Morgan, Gap, and Balenciaga have canceled their deals with Kanye. Adidas follows suit, being the final nail in the coffin for the now millionaire. Personally, I think it was when Kanye challenged Adidas to cancel him that he really took the L.
The thing about it, me and Adidas, is like, I could literally say anti-Semitic shit and they can't drop me. I could say anti-Semitic things and Adidas can't drop me. Now what? Now what?
Adidas was ready to lose up to $1 billion in sales just to get rid of Kanye, which tells you how strongly they felt about all this. After this turmoil, Ye goes to visit Donald Trump with big-time loser degenerate and scum of the fucking earth, Nick Loserboy Fuentes. Reports are that Trump was pissed and he kicked them out. I mean, this is what we get from the tweets. After this time, Kanye announces his bid for presidency. Kanye appears on another interview with Alex Delusions of Grandeur Jones. And in this interview, he praises Hitler for the millionth time. But to my surprise, even Alex was dumbfounded by the experience.
Of it. And now people are like, wait a second, the so-called crime doesn't deserve the punishment. What did I thought?
Well, that's right. You're not Hitler. You're not a Nazi. You don't deserve to be called that and demonized.
Well, I see good things about Hitler also. I love everyone, and Jewish people are not going to tell me you can love us, and you can love what we're doing to you with the contracts, and you can love what we're, you know, what we're pushing with the pornography. But this guy that invented highways, invented the very microphone that I use as a musician, you can't say out loud that this person ever did anything good. And I'm done with that. I'm done with the classifications. Every human being has something of value that they brought to the table, especially Hitler. How about that one? Ari Emanuel, how you like that one? Hey, Ron, you gonna do anything to fix Chicago?
Hitler said he loved Hitler. They gave him an award. I'm just saying, I don't like Nazis, and I don't like what some of the mafias are doing either.
I like Hitler.
And since then, after a few more interviews and rants, Kanye finally went quiet and has been silently working throughout all of 2023. This is why I'm talking about him today, because of the soon-to-be-released album known as Vultures. And before release, this album has been coupled with issues. And knowing the fact that it is delayed, which is a common occurrence only true Kanye fans know, Kanye has been interjecting a lot of anti-Semitic themes into the album, for the teaser, to the album art, and even the lyrics. And I have a lot of fear going into this album, and I wanted to share that with you guys today as a fan of Kanye's music. First, let me talk about my history of Kanye. The first time I heard Kanye was actually in a commercial during the time Graduation came out. I may have been 10, but I was definitely a youngin'. And this was a Yahoo commercial, so it was very old. And the weather's so breezy. Man, why can't life always be this easy?
What do you know? No. Stay close to the spotlight with the number one online source for entertainment news. Make Yahoo your home.
Since then, I have been hooked. I listen to everything from the album releases to the official mixtapes, as well as the unofficial ones. I became a fan of the music, and with many parts, the man. This was someone who works every day during the summers in Chicago to get out his dreams. He's an inspiration to young niggas like me that are aiming for the stars. And I still admire that part of him. I had been a fan of the music until we got to Yeezy. Now, I enjoyed Daft Punk, and I know they helped with the album, but I never liked the sound of the album. Black Skinhead and a lot of the other songs were just not my jam. But I did enjoy Blood on the Leaves and Bound 2. Now, when it came to The Life of Pablo, before the title remastering, I thought it was a callback to Kanye from my childhood, and I loved it. I personally think this album is second only to My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. Then we went into God's Territory fully for a bit, and it was fine. Jesus is King, not a bad album. And then we had a not-so-cool reflection phase with, I think I'm Bipolar, right? It was not a great album. And all of this is leading up to the new album, Vultures, which, as a fan of the music, I am very nervous about. But more on that later. Next, let's talk about mental health. I understand more than most that our authentic self is not the one we portray in the world. For whatever underlying reason, there is something preventing us from doing so. How much we show to people varies, and that's okay, because trust shouldn't be a commodity. It has to be earned. And with so many people in this world, there are people you may have met that you would never consider to have cognitive impairments. Whether that be depression, ADHD, PTSD, body dysmorphia, you name it, you just wouldn't know. And I like to think the reason why is because any rational human would understand that in life, you're dealt a deck of cards, and you gotta figure out how to use them the best you can. It is because of that that I believe many can have compassion for one another. Now, with all of that being said, utilizing and weaponizing your own mental illness as a way to trauma dump in order to justify or embolden your self-destructive actions or attributes and imposing that shit onto other people makes you a shit person. I like to think this is a solid, encompassing statement on how I feel about it. I do not have compassion for the yay that is being impulsive and saying crazy shit just because he has to go against what quote unquote they say. I just can't. Now, the biggest issue we face here is separating the art from the artist. Now, I've made a video on this previously, which I will link as well. So I'm not going to get too deep into this, but in short, I see art as its own entity that means something different to the person listening. As members of Jurassic 5 once said, the music is the soul, and the soul is the music. I like to think that is true, but I need to recognize the part of the artist that promotes an aspect of their life to their audience. Whether it is a concept, idea, or lifestyle, there's going to be some messaging always. And while I do think there are some songs that can utilize this and transcend that purpose, there are just as many songs full of ill intent. And that brings us to Vultures. I have not heard any songs or leaks. I'm personally waiting for the official drop. However, here's everything about Vultures that has been summed up by Fantano, the busiest music nerd.
The save page for Kanye and Ty Dolla $ign's new album Vultures is now down off stream. Who cares about that? Let's talk about how Kanye is still on this Nazi shit. So as some of you guys have probably seen, he's been placing this very particular double-headed bird crest in numerous visuals around the promotion of the record. And it is very much giving German nationalism vibes. There is also, of course, the album art, which is very clearly ripping off the album art of Burzum. a Scandinavian black metal artist who has very publicly voiced white supremacist views. Meanwhile, the landscape itself depicted here on the album cover was done by a German artist who at one point was very much favored by the Nazis, which you can read right here below. And let's be clear, he had nothing to do with them personally. He died long before they were in power. So Kanye is very much doing this weird white supremacist breadcrumbing once again. Two things. One, don't allow his annoying ass fan base, or really cult, because that's what his fan base is at this point, a cult. Don't allow them to gaslight you into thinking that it's not happening and it's not real and it doesn't exist. It is real. And two, why is Kanye doing this? And it's got to be for one of two reasons. One, Kanye not too long ago went on that whole, you know, white supremacist jaunt where he was palling around with white supremacists and endorsing Hitler. And now he just wants to work racist symbolism into his art as a means of maybe disarming any criticisms that people might still have around it, which honestly only an idiot would fall for, and is a coward's way of kind of stepping around the necessity to apologize for and fess up to the things that you said and the things that you did. And the other possible option is that he actually believes in this stuff and thinks it's true. Either way, it's not good.
And with all of this symbolism, who is to say what the music sounds like? This is why I'm afraid of the album. But I will say, music is usually a collaborative effort. There are many rappers that I think are terrible, but they have some of the best producers in the game. And I mean the best, from Metro Boomin to Hit-Boy, the best. The music may be amazing, because Kanye is just that goated of a producer himself. But the words and symbolism that he may implement is what I fear the most, not just for me and my image of my hero being destroyed continuously, but for the younger generations that are going to be influenced by this. You know how many people actually find Yeezy to be their favorite album? Out of all the albums he made, they think Black Skinhead, an album with Black Skinhead on it, is one of the best albums. That's troubling. That's very concerning. Or they think that one song where he did Scoopity Boopity Boppity Bop, they think that song's good too? Like, I just worry about this generation. So with all of that, thank you for watching until the end. If you enjoyed the video, let me know in the comments, and most definitely subscribe. We're on the road to 500, so please, help me out. Stay blessed, and if you don't hear from me, happy holidays. This is Sun Tsunami, shining out. Peace.